called carcinoma in situ. Carcinoma basically means pre-cancer, and the in situ means like now, within. So the whole piece is it's directed more towards breast cancer, and because I always, being an all-woman dance company, I always try and empower things on women. And even though we are touching a subject that's quite sensitive, but everybody out there and somebody we know in family or friends have some form of cancer. Many colleagues and friends that have different forms of cancer, and that some have actually had mastectomies. I've got a male friend that's actually got lung cancer. So it's so much in our lives that I think it's just, you know, when it's part of your life, you want to sometimes deal with it. And we, with our dancing, we deal with our and through our art, we deal with our coping with friends and colleagues that have to go through. You know, it's in everyday life. I don't think anybody doesn't know somebody who hasn't either had cancer or is suffering with cancer. We talk about the pre-cancer stages of breast cancer, and or we dance through it, should I say? But we try and finish on a positive outlook, and that with the use of friends and friendship and support within that you must always be positive and go forward in life.
It started when I was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2008, but yeah, I think it actually started before that, 2007, which is one of the images on the show. I knew that I had the lump, and I had denied it for about 2 years, actually, until I finally got up the courage to go and face it and accept that, yes, I did have cancer. It wasn't deliberate when I started the project. For me, it was just an internal necessity to document myself, because I do document other people. And I only realize now with time how this work does affect other people. I just want to say to them, feel free with your body. And we have to forget this media image of the perfect breast, the perfect hair, that, you know, they try and give us these images which are completely unattainable. And then I think most women spend their lives not loving themselves. I think it's been an incredible healing experience, because it helped me to look at my trauma, look at the photographs afterwards, and then put them out on the wall. And every time I take the exhibition down, it's also, again, just closing another chapter, closing the illness, making it further and further away. Art is that it opens up questions and avenues and opens up these kind of secrets. I know that a lot of women who have had breast cancer or whose mothers have had breast cancer have come to see the show, and it does help them in some sense that also one can survive, you know, and I think a lot of that has got to do with your attitude and how you deal with it.